Finn's palace was on the top of a hill called Knockmany, and it looked out on another mountain called Cullamore, and there was a deep gorge in between. Finn had settled there so he could see his enemies a long way off, and as well as that, he could throw the bodies of his prey into the gorge for the crows to fatten themselves on. "Oh, my bilberry," said Finn as he saw his wife Oonagh, who had plaited her hair and put on a silk dress to please him. At once Finn asked if the reason she had sent for him was true. "'Tis true, Eivik," said Oonagh, and went on to tell him how MMcConigle had pitched a tent at the far side of the province and had his famous thunderbolt in the shape of a pancake in his pocket and called himself the Invincible. Finn put his thumb into his mouth to verify all these things and found out that they were true. He could only use his gift of prophecy on very trying and solemn occasions such as this. "Finn, darling, don't bite your thumb," said Oonagh very sweetly as she led him into the house where there was a dinner prepared. Finn squatted at one end of the low table, Oonagh at the other, and along with maidens to wait on them, there were harpists playing in order to soothe Finn. He started by having 16 duck eggs, 8 pig's crubbeens, and 3 raw onions for his digestion. The main course was a haunch of roast venison, and it was so long that it stretched between them down the length of the table, a sizzling roast dotted with berries and all sorts of herbs. But no matter how much he ate or drank, there was a frown on Finn's forehead and a big brown ridge like a furrow on the bridge of his nose because of his thinking. "Dearest," said Oonagh as she bobbed along and began to stroke his great naked back. Finn always removed his cloak before he sat down to eat. "You'll best him. You always do," said Oonagh. But Finn shook his head and said it was perilous, because according to his thumb, he and MMcConigle had equal amounts of strength, ate the same amount of food, weighed the same, and were equally matched in daring, wisdom, and cunning. "What else does it say?" Oonagh asked, and Finn put his thumb right inside his mouth and shut his eyes in order to concentrate. "Take care you don't draw blood," said Oonagh. "He's coming," said Finn. "He's below in Dungannon." And at that, he jumped up. "When will he be here?" said Oonagh. "He'll be here before long," said Finn, and he began to put his vest and his jacket on. He looked at his wife, and for the first time, she saw fear and apprehension in his eyes. She decided that she would have to help him and make use of her own enchantments.
"For too long, I've been a stranger.